Hey, back again for another little roundup of things and see how things are going. What I've done here, I've started working on this deck. You'll see I've put these little hoops which form a frame for the this little throne thing for the captain or master of the ship. I've also put a lot of these little ties on. 23 of them all together. There's four up there. You're supposed to tie up one of the little blocks, the rigging blocks, to that, but I haven't done that yet. What I have done as well, I'll just show you. This is the sheet of seals that come with this little kit. And this here is not actually a seal, but you're meant to use this, bend it around the cut it out and bend it around that frame there so it forms that little cover for it. But I'm fairly sure I could make something better looking than that. So that's what I'm going to try for that. I'll show you me doing that. Then the last little thing I'm just going to show you is I've prepared some more of these little figures here. Let's see if we can zoom in a bit. All right. That's the leader figure, and then there's the guy beating the drum and the guy with the whip, and I've also, this is the little drum thing that he's beating. Okay, just made it look a bit worn. I'm going to glue those into the ship, into the front up here. I was thinking the little commander guy could do him looking out, and then the drum and the other guy beating that. But what I thought I'd show you before I do that is just me removing these figures from the sprue, because I've had a trouble with the flash on these and cleaning them up. I've just really got nowhere very much. And I'm using these Tamiya sharp, what are they called? Sharp or something like that. Side cutters. Have I just, you can see that okay? Just clip it under the other foot. You can see it still has flash on that, which is really annoying. Because other than that, these figures are quite nice. Right, there he is. He's off the base. Probably shouldn't have let him fall so hard. It damaged the paintwork. That's that one. Then this one. And then lastly, this one. This one's got three attachment points on it. I've got to get them all. Don't think I quite completely got that one. There we go. That's those three off. Keep those for spares or whatever. Still got to do all the upper deck and everything. Alright, so one. Ooh, come out from under there. Two, three. They're all just basically painted because you're not really going to see them once I put the top deck on. Back in a minute. Okay. Here you can see some of the little men that I've put in the front of the boat, and you can see, I think, there, you can see one of them is actually looking at. A bit lonely. And here's the little house, big house sort of thing, arrangement. And I put some paper over the little seat that was in there just to make it look a bit, just a little bit more luxurious as well. So that's that part. Back again for a very quick update. This is just to show you that I've put the deck in place. The mast is there temporarily. And I've also replaced the vacuum molded deck house thing. Little captain's place with a piece of paper just wrapped over. And then I've used to... this matte medium to stick the paper to it by just basically soaking the paper in that. Anyway, that isn't really what I wanted to talk about. What I wanted to talk about was the deck here. It didn't sit quite exactly. You can see that, okay. There was gaps all along. Not just this side, the other side as well. So what I've done, as you can see there, I've used these clips to hold it in place. And if it's been sitting overnight, if I take those off, two and three. You can see if I zoom in, okay, well, just got interrupted there for a second. You can see the deck there. I wouldn't say it's perfect, but once it's painted, I don't think you'll notice it. I'll show you the other side very quickly. This side, actually, strangely enough, this side wasn't anywhere near so bad. It was just the other side that wouldn't sit down properly. I used those three clips that I showed you, and I moved them along as I glued each section. Left them for a few minutes and then moved them. And I think that's done the job. So that's that part. The other part I wanted to talk about was this. Maybe you remember earlier, I said that here, there's very shiny plastic here and it sort of is out of place because there's a wood grain effect on the rest of most of the ship. And again, we have, so along here, this is just completely smooth. I don't know if it's meant to be covered in metal or something, or I don't know, sheets of wood, but there's no indication of that, and there's no wood grain or anything. So what I'm thinking is, I've got a, see if I can get it out now, behind these instructions, I've got this implement, plastic scriber 2 from Tamiya, and I was going to, the structure in the back, mark up this area along here with some masking tape maybe, and then scribe some panel lines that way or this way. According to my bireme book, the bireme in there does have planking. Here's the book, this one. You can see a little bit even on the front cover. Let's see if I can find a better illustration of it. There's the one there. See there? You can see that the planking along there. Okay. And so I'm going to try and replicate that in some way on here. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do next. Bye. Okay, back again. Just to show you what I've done. I've used this Tamiya masking tape, this 6mm, I think. This fairly thin one. And I put a couple of lines of it along here. And then I tried to use the panel line scriber, panel line engraver, whatever you want to call it, to scribe some boards along this, which was otherwise completely flat. And as I saw from the Byron book, it didn't seem to look right. So I had a go at that, and I'd say, well, let's just leave that there. See if I can zoom in on it. It didn't really work out, because obviously I could put the tape down, okay, but the scriber wouldn't exactly follow. So I've got a lot of wonky looking planks, which would be all right if this was, let me, an old shed or something. But I'm not sure if for my Imperial Roman Byrim it's entirely appropriate. It's the same on the other side, basically. I'll just turn it over so you can see. I just assembled the stand just to put the ship on for now. Let's zoom in. Again, you can see the, it's not the, best of even planking or anything. So what I'm going to do, the funny thing is, I still think it looks pretty good. So I'm not going to just rush and do away with it, fill it in or anything like that, or try again. I'm going to paint it and see how it looks. And then if it doesn't work, I have one more idea, which I'll show you in just a second. Okay, this is my alternative idea. This is some wood veneer. Okay, and you can see it's pretty thin. It's not exactly paper thin, but it's nearly. And I can easily, I hope, cut that to shape to cover that up. However you want to do it one or two pieces like that. And then once it got to shape, I could fairly easily scribe some lines into this and then stick it on with some PVA glue. That'll cover up that top board. I could always try do one side with this, leave the other side with this sort of rickety planking effect that I've got. So I'm going to think about that. I'll leave that piece of veneer to one side. Okay, so that's what I've got. And next thing I've got to do, I think, is maybe start a bit of painting, or there might be a few more little bits to put on the deck first. Okay, see you in a while. Hi all, back again with a quick progress report. What I've done is, you can see over here the rudder assembly. Let's just lift it up so you can see it properly. Okay, that's what that looks like. There's a little platform there for the steersman to stand on. I suppose really these two should be connected, should they? Maybe. So they both turn the same way. I've got the masks in as well at the moment. Both the main mast and this bowsprit type mast. I've left off the railings just because they're getting away. I'm going to do some painting. And on the topic of painting, what I intend to do is when I'm making little figures, I use blocks like these. They're very cheap. You get them on, I think, Amazon or some other shopping site probably. And then I paint over them like this. There's some snipers that I painted before, and I like the effect I can get here. And what I'm using here is artist's acrylic paint over the top. So this is completely painted, so even though it is actually, you know, starts off as natural wood anyway, you can't see any of the wood afterwards. Just that, and I'll show you that these are the paints I'm going to be using. There's 12 in this set, but I only use two of them usually, maybe three. Okay, I could possibly use a bit of that green that's in there, right in the middle. I'll just show you the two colours that I tend to use, which are yellow ochre on the right and raw amber on the left. And obviously these come out of the tube, they're pretty thick. I'll show you all that in a minute, but you can just mix these randomly and they and use a stiff brush, like, let's see, something like this maybe, pretty stiff brush to brush them on. And they do go on thick, and they take a while to dry as well. But you get a sort of natural, as you could see with this kind of finish, you get a natural kind of a wood grain type pattern. And then I can go back in and paint in detail anything like the rudders, or obviously that wheelhouse, or not wheelhouse, but the deck house. I've got to do something fancy with that, and the masts and everything like that. And do individual planks as well. Do them up fancy. So that's what I'm going to do next. Back in a minute. Okay, I just thought I'd show you the how these paints look when they come out. So I've got the ochre, the yellow ochre. And that one, it's sort of... That's going to be the basic colour. That's that one. And then the raw amber one. I'll put it in there. Close those up. Then I can use, let's see, I can move back over to where the ship is. Let's take out the mast. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a bit of this, a bit of that, and mix them, but not quite. So they're a bit like that. Colours all over the place. Hopefully you saw that. Did you see that okay? Alright, they're sort of mixed a bit in the middle. Then I could really just start... Well, let's see, let's do here. Let's see. You can, of course, thin this, but I don't usually. Paint away. If it starts to look too dark, then like this, just mix a bit more white in. It takes a while for this paint to dry. I don't know exactly how long. I can put a bit more. That's my palette making that rattling noise. That's a bit annoying. I'll do the rest of this little bit and then I'll show you how it looks. As I say, I'm using quite a stiff brush. And because these paints are not thoroughly mixed, you're going to be getting a random effect. And if that's not enough, just, you know, dip the brush back in again into the paints. It's going to give you a bit of texture as well, because this paint is thick. It's not a huge amount. You can make it more. You can keep the paint thick if you want. And I think I might anyway end up putting either a decal or hand painting a design over this part of the ship, like a serpent or maybe the Roman god Neptune, god of the sea. And you can keep working with this paint for quite a long time. And what I'll do, I'll just lift this up to the camera. Well, actually, let's zoom in. I can get on the right place. Okay. You'll see it picks, when you do this technique, it picks up the textures quite nicely. And you can vary the color pretty much to whatever way you want to. Okay, so what I'll do, that's what I'm going to do, the whole ship like that now. I'll probably do the deck a slightly different color, so I might come back and show you doing that. But I'm going to do all, most of the ship now. I might have to skip a bit so that it can sit down. Okay, back in a minute. Okay, just another quick update. I've done about half the ship. So I've done the deck there. I've added a hint of lemon into the deck to lighten it. And you can see, let's see if I can zoom in somewhere. You can see the effect. Obviously the paint is wet at the moment. It will dry a bit flatter than that, and I'll finish off that detail. But I find this bit really enjoyable because it's more like painting than a model kit, because you're just freehanding it with the brush. And this paint, it takes a while to dry and everything, so you've got time to mess around with it, move it, mix it, all that kind of stuff. I definitely would recommend this. If you haven't tried this technique before on things, then give it a go. Maybe you know some better ways of doing it than I do. Okay, so there you go. I'll come back when I do the next part of it. See you then. Okay, well, welcome back again. I finished all of the basic painting. It's still wet, so I can't move it or anything, but you can see there, I can zoom in a bit, If you have a look at the deck, you can see some of the little oarsmen in there. Okay, so that's that. Once that's dry, I'll be able to give you a better look at it. And then we'll have to tidy it up and do some extra bits and so on. What also arrived today, though, which I think you might be interested in, is I bought some of these. I'm going to straighten that up without breaking it. This is AB figures, I think it is. 15mm Imperial Romans. That's one. That's another one. These are high quality figures. I mean, for 15mm, they're really good. And here's the boss man. He would look good, wouldn't he? Stood near the wheelhouse. Obviously, have to take his base off and everything. Anyway, there he is. You can see there's plenty of detail on him compared to the some of the plastic figures I looked at. I've got some legionaries marching as well. I thought I could just sort of put them standing around the deck. And then these ones. Again, great detail on these. And where there is a bit of flash or whatever. And there's a bit there, you can see. It can be very easy to clean up compared to the soft plastic figures. I'll just show you this last one since I might as well. A musician, Cornicern. I mean, these are pretty small figures. I was wondering if I could, for example, match them up with, let's see. These are hat Imperial Roman command figures. I'm pretty sure that's what they are anyway. 8075, it says on the sprues. That's all it says. But you can see here, there's various officers, musicians, etc. So might just a little bit. Here, there's all their standards and so on. And if we zoom in a bit here, you can see that these are pretty well detailed too. Different shields, round ones, oval. And there's a couple of blocks there. They look like they're sticks, but are they spears? I don't know. Okay, so what I was thinking of was, AB figures compatible scale wise because they're 15mm and the hat figures are 172, which they're almost the same height, but I don't really think they're compatible. Like that guy probably is about the smallest of them. Let's try one of these, which is a similar sort of figure, but you can see they're still too small and not sturdy compared to the other ones. These are much more, these AB figures are much more lifelike in that sense. So maybe I'll have to save them for another occasion, or I could just use the AB figures for this ship. Anyway, that's for a later date, but I've got all the figures now, I think, and I've also got various let's compare them to 28mm figure, Imperial Roman. So the red ones are the hat, and then the grey ones are Warlord Games figures, I think. Let's zoom right in. See if we can put two right beside each other. You can see the difference there. The sturdiness of the War Games figures. Even though they're not that much taller, they're an awful lot more chunky. I don't think I could use the 28mm figures with the 1/72 scale figures. But what I could do perhaps is use the shields, get some stickers for those, and then make them look fancy. Go along the side of the ship when I put the railings on. You can see how the shields compare in size. So the 28mm ones are a lot bigger. But then if you compare it to the man, the shields are not, well, compared to that one, obviously, because he's holding the shield. The shields are not that much out of proportion. And they'll be on the side of the railings. Okay, well, anyway, all these decisions are for later. And I'll decide what to do when everything's ready. But anyway, so this the ship is pretty much prepared as a basic, at a basic level. And I'll go back and I'll be doing individual planks and also things like this at the deck house. And there's railings and decorations here and etc. I was thinking, as I think I mentioned already, but to paint like a serpent along here, maybe just freehand one, or maybe I'll get a decal. I've also managed to source some rigging thread from other old model kits to start doing the rigging, etc. So yeah, anyway, that's the end of that update. See you next time. Bye. Okay, well, here's the current update. You'll see I've painted, for example, the beak at the front, or ram, whatever you want to call that. Specifically, what I'm doing just at this moment is I've prepared some decals. This is a laser jet paper. This is the one with the white background. And I was going to put one of these either side of the little deck house there. So what I'll do, I'll cut those out and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, well, I just wanted to show you that other little clip of the decals on the paper so you could see. This is white decal paper, I think I mentioned already. So I've got two of those, one for each side. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to use some of this, paint it on. Let's go fairly liberally, but I don't want it to run too much. I measured up the decals and everything to make sure, so far as I could anyway, unless I've got it wrong, that they fitted. So that's that done. Put that out of the way. Take one of these decals, pop it in the some water. Actually, what I'm gonna do, I know I've made a mess of that, I'll be back in a minute. Yeah, sorry about that. I just noticed the water I was using, it wasn't that clean. Okay. So I just quickly went and got some new, or some clean water. The decal has completely come off the paper. So I'll get it in position. Get something to maneuver it with. Let's get it sticky. Are you going to go down there? Alright. Sticking to me. Sticking to the model. Some kind of effect, like a sort of a static electricity is pulling the decal towards the little wheelhouse. Okay, so it's in position. It's approximately at least where I wanted it to be. Then I'm going to quickly brush some more of this off. I'm going to soften it and make it comply with the shape of the little deck house. Alright, that's that one done. Okay, I've got to turn off the camera now just because it's a lot easier to do this off camera. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, back again. And you can see I've done, well, I can't quite see from there, but I have done both sides of the deck house. I've also done, I've painted this in gold color and say along there, done this on both sides. It's actually brass coloured, and there. And then I went over it with some Reichland flesh shade to sort of give it some more contrast, etc. So what I'm going to do next is I have some, I think, some of this colour, army paint, greedy gold, because it's a very bright sort of gold. Might even put some silver in with it to highlight, see along here, and possibly along there as well. Okay. And that little sun face and everything. Anyway, that's where I've got with the ship so far, and you've seen me put the decals on just now, so let's see how they turn out. See you in a minute. Okay, all. I think I'll make this the last bit of this little video because it's getting a bit too long, maybe. What I'm going to do, just I'll sort of start off, is see this scroll work, this decorative work on here. I've already painted it gold, and then I've gone over it with Reichland flesh shade to give it some depth. And what I'm going to do now is use this one, greedy gold, plus a little bit of this steel to create a highlight color. I've already mixed these up. I'll have another quick mix. Alright, let's put some on the palette. I'll just show you the start of this and then I'll... maybe just show you it finished. I've mixed up some paint, but I've put too much, like way too much silver in it. I'm putting on a bit of the gold in it. Oh, it's a bit lumpy. Just mix that well. Let's see how that goes. I don't want to do all of this on camera because it's a bit fiddly. I've got to lift up the whole ship and everything. So if I just do that. I'm using a small paintbrush. It's a synthetic paintbrush. Oh no, it isn't. Jarvis 00 Pure Sable, it says. I've got a load of these brushes from a long, long time ago. This should really bring out the the detail of these scrolls. Kind of therapeutic, this. You have to calm down when you're doing it. If it does appear, maybe a bit too silver. You can always go back again later, because there might be the odd correction to make anyway. Maybe I could have just done this with the greedy gold color. I can always try that on the other side or on another piece. Alright, can you see that effect? Hopefully that shows up clearly on the camera. So I'll finish that off now, and then I'll come back to you in a different video. Next I'll do these little decorations along here. And then after that, I've got the... Let me just show you. Got the masts, there's one. The other one. Got the railings. They're all painted up. All ready to go. I'm going to build a new base out of wood. Bolts of wood or something. To put it on. And so there's a bit to do. And obviously there's all the rigging as well. And then the oars. Oars to do. And then perhaps finally some crew to dot here and there around the ship. Okay, well, I hope you've been enjoying this video so far. I've been really enjoying making this little ship. And, all sorts of things going on here. All right, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.